catch up to.
Michael and I have worked together since the beginning of his career, and we've worked so much, we can work so fast, and we've developed a lot of different shorthand techniques and a lot of different ways of approaching this that make it fast. And I think one thing we're proud of, I know Michael's proud of and I'm proud of, I try to create an atmosphere so that the orchestra can go for it. If they make a mistake, so be it, there always is another take. These orchestra members, many of them are people I've worked with over 20 to 30 years. A lot of them are friends, a lot of them are, so there's a rapport that I have with them that you don't normally have with studio players, and it does make things go faster, and it makes it more enjoyable because I know so many people in the orchestra, I just know them on a personal level. Michael is coming to the franchise and yet bringing his own little touch and doing new themes. Even this Into the Darkness is totally different thematic material, a lot of it. We hear a couple themes that were introduced in the first Star Trek, but there's a lot of new thematic material. There's a new theme we hear a lot of. So he has taken it and he's continuing it. Not just rehashing the first one, but actually taking it further now in the second. This picture has a little bit of synth, which for Michael, I don't think the last one did. Just some little effects and ideas. The last one had much more choir. This one is not going choir as much. Brass-wise, it's very similar. We didn't do anything much different with that. It's little differences, but they make a difference in the end run. It starts with JJ and it ends with JJ. He has to have the script, the vision, he directs it. We're the last step. An important last step that provides emotion, a lot of intangibles that I know JJ, one, appreciates, and that's the most important thing. JJ loves orchestra and he appreciates the contribution of what the score does. And he lets Michael do what he needs to do and he understands it. And yet he always has his hand in it knowing, even though he'll musically change things if it's not quite right, because he has a very good instinct for what he wants in the scene. And then it's for Michael to interpret it, and then me as the orchestrator maybe to interpret it one more step in how to exactly get what JJ wanted to happen at any certain moment of the film, to have the orchestra do that exact thing that just conforms to JJ's visions. it's very enjoyable to be part of this. It's never lost on me how wonderful studio musicians are and how much of a privilege it is to do this. I drove in with my wife on the Fox lot today and I said, I remember dreaming about working on film lots when I lived in Chicago 30, 40 years ago now. And now I'm doing it. And I want to savor it. I don't want to not appreciate it because they're very special times. So I'm thrilled to be a part of this process and to work with creative, wonderful people like all these studio musicians, like the engineers, like the crew, like Michael and like JJ. To be part of all this, to be a small part of all this is a wonderful privilege, and I cherish it.